right. Looks like we've got just about everyone. How are we doing?
Internal security remains solid. I've caught 3 Imperial spies since Ossus. 2 attempted to enlist, and the other presented herself as a merchant seeking new trade relations. Unfortunately, they fled before they could be caught and interrogated about their specific objectives.
It's good to know we're still so popular.
I suppose that's one way of looking at it.
My assets have brought in solid intel from all of the major battles along the front lines. I'll keep forwarding everything to Baywan for analysis.
My people are using that intel to create new write-ups for the major field commanders on both sides. Should help us predict strategic probabilities going forward. Until we get a specific request for aid, I've deployed our fleet in a defensive posture around Odessen. Speaking of ships, one of our frigates went AWOL. The crew is ex-Imperial, so we're pretty sure they're heading back home. I can't blame them for not sticking around to fight their old allies, but that ship wasn't theirs to take. How should I deal with them?
Track them down, but stick with your ion cannons. I only want the ship back. Crew members are free to go where they like.
Understood. Once our people have retaken the frigate, they'll drop the crew off at the closest neutral port.
Nothing so dramatic occurring in our science lab. Improvements to Odessen's planetary shields have been successfully completed.
All right. Hilo?
We've had to step up security for my crews. Piracy is becoming a bigger problem on their runs. Lucky for us, you're friends with Mandalore. Now that word spread that her people are riding along, nobody messes with our transports.
Good to hear. Anything else?
Me and the crew have been running one of the old Thranta corvettes. We're patrolling the route between here and Sakul. It's bad over there. Some of the city spires have closed themselves off completely. Others are actually taking shots at each other. And those gangsters from the exchange? They're moving in all over the place. Nearly half the provisional government is tied to them somehow. I know they want to go their own way. But Sakul is my home. It's home for a lot of our people. I think we should try to help.
How do you think we could help them?
The most important thing is to get the exchange out of there. The Knights are practically non-existent now. There's no law. I know it's not our place to go after them on Sakul, so let's go after them before they get there. Give me 3 extra ships, and we'll intercept any exchange members we find headed for Sakul. Without any muscle or bribes to back them up, they'll crumble.
Sounds like a good plan. The ships are yours, Koth.
Thank you. Gonna enjoy taking those scumbags down.
Sana Ray is touring the reconstruction efforts on Vos, so I believe we're finished.
That's all I have. Good work, everyone.
There was one final matter for you. We received a message from Alec Raynan, a reporter for a Republic news network. He'd like to speak when you have a moment. I've loaded his frequency into your holocom.
Thought we could use a moment alone. I have to say, it feels good to work with the Republic again. We spent so many years dealing with Suresh and people like her. It's easy to lose faith. To forget what we all signed up for in the first place. Republic might finally be ready to live up to its own standards. I'm glad to be a part of it.
The Republic has always been my home. It feels good to be back after so long.
Plus, Coruscant has way better restaurants than Dromund Kaas. I'm glad we could talk. I'll catch you later.
Commander, what a pleasure. Alec Raynan, Republic News Network. Your little comeback is everybody talking. Would you like to join the conversation?
What do you have in mind exactly?
Oh, nothing too formal. You, me, and a friendly conversation about the Alliance and the Republic. I think it would boost morale for people to hear about how you're going to win this nasty old war for us. How about it?
I need to know more about the questions you plan to ask.
Really basic stuff. Where you come from, how you save the galaxy, how you'll save the Republic. Totally boilerplate, I promise. We film in a studio on Carrot Station. Meet me there when you're ready.
Jonas, did you set up this interview request?
Of course not, but I'll pull some strings. I'll make sure you get a nice big audience. This is a great chance to inspire the people of the Republic. Don't forget to dress sharp.
Commander, welcome. Follow me and we'll get started. Our studio is just this way.
Live in 3, 2,
Welcome back to Republic News. I'm your host, Alec Rainin. Our guest tonight has led a rather illustrious career as an esteemed member of the Jedi Order. But nowadays, you're simply known as the Commander, leader of the alliance that overthrew the Zakulian Empire, a hero to the entire galaxy. How does it feel to return to the Republic?
The Alliance hasn't officially joined the Republic yet, but we are siding with the Republic in the war.
An important distinction. I think we're happy to have all the allies we can get. Some people in your position might have felt abandoned given the Republic's treaty with Sakul precluded any official support for the Alliance. Is that why you chose to support the Sith Empire on Iokath? Because you felt abandoned by the Republic?
Next question.
Very well. At the request of Republic personnel, you defended the Jedi colony on Osus when it came under Imperial attack. It was during that attack that we learned of the survival of Darth Malgus, possibly the Empire's most feared battle commander. How did his reappearance make you feel?
Malgus is dangerous, but we've beaten him before. We can do it again.
Your confidence is reassuring. I'm afraid we're just about out of time, so let's get to the heart of things. The war against the Sith Empire. Can we win?
With the Alliance joining forces with the Republic, the Empire doesn't stand a chance.
I like the sound of that. Any final comments before we wrap up?
The Republic is a place where all the peoples of the galaxy come together to create something greater than ourselves. If we're going to win, we'll do it by working together to bring out the best in everyone.
Inspiring words indeed. Thank you so much to our special guest. I'm Alec Rainin. Good night, and stay strong.
Transmission complete.
Great show. We'll have to bring you back again soon.
Great work, Commander. You looked good, and you sounded even better.
Escort 1 to Overlord. Scanning for hostiles now. I'm detecting some strange interference.
Republic fighters, evade!
Great shooting, people. Scratch 1 destroyer.
Looks like the captain of the destroyer is making a run for it.
They're not going anywhere.
Great shooting. Let's regroup.
Commander!
General Daerun, what can I do for you?
I'm glad I caught you. Darth Malgus is assembling one of the largest attack fleets in history. We need your help.
What else do we know? Do we have the fleet's objective?
We should discuss that in person. We're in the operations center on Karak Station. Please hurry, Commander. Daerun out.
More than 100 capital ships, with smaller picket ships and support vessels close by. And that's not all. There's enough fuel transports for all those warships to cross half the galaxy. Darth Malgus is leaving nothing to chance. His fleet won't stop until they reach the objective.
Which is...
Corellia.
It's a pleasure to see you again, Master.
I never had the chance to properly thank you for your help on Osus. Many people owe you their lives.
The fleet's target is the Meridian Complex, a state-of-the-art shipyard that's due to begin production in a matter of weeks. The Meridian Complex can produce new warships at triple the speed of any existing shipyard, and at half the energy cost.
Once that shipyard becomes operational,
It could give the Republic a significant advantage in a matter of months. That's why they're committing so many ships to this mission. The Sith Empire will stop at nothing to destroy this new shipyard before it can save the Republic's war effort.
How long can the shipyard's defenses hold out against a fleet that size?
A matter of hours, at best. That's where you come in. It's crucial that we redeploy the Republic fleet to defend the Meridian Complex immediately. Unlike Malgus, we can't move our ships to Corellia without refueling stops. We expect the Empire's top agents to target our reinforcements anywhere they stop. They won't risk our forces arriving in time to make a difference. We want you to defend and expedite those reinforcements as best you can. If we defeat the Empire at Corellia, we turn the tide of this war in our favor.
All right, where am I going first?
The planet Onderon. The 11th Fleet is gathering there to resupply and refuel before heading to Corellia. It's the only Republic port within range of their current position.
Onderon has been a Republic world for centuries, but local politics have become strained and fractious. Tawadere is already investigating. She suspects Imperial infiltration.
I'll be glad to work with Tau again.
She feels the same way. You made a very effective team on Ossus.
General, word from the 87th.
I'll leave you to it, Commander. Good luck.
Speaking of Tau, I have one more favor to ask of you, Commander. Arn, if you please.
Commander, I'm looking forward to meeting you. I'm Arn Perallan, Jedi Padawan.
I remember Nos D'Aral and Tau talking about her taking on a Padawan. Is that you?
Apparently so.
Tau had to leave for Onderon before I could introduce her new Padawan. Since you're heading there anyway, I thought Arn might ride along with you. The Commander is one of us, Arn. Heed her well. May the Force be with you both.
Artillery fire. On Dacot 7.
What?
How'd it happen? How'd you get injured? Yeah, that's everyone's first question. My master and I were escorting refugees. He died. I survived. More or less. Dacot 7 has advanced technology, but the locals can't use Kolto or Bacta. Genetically incompatible, they said. So they use cybernetics to treat all their severe injuries. Their recovery took years. I don't know if I can still become the Jedi I hoped to be, but I'm not giving up now.
The Force is strong with you, Arn. I can feel it. I'm sure you'll become a great Jedi.
Thanks. It feels good to return to the Jedi path after so long. Hey, before we go, my new master, Tau, what can you tell me about her?
Tau has all the best qualities we aim to uphold. She's courageous, dutiful, determined. She'll teach you well.
Master Nos D'Aral thinks very highly of her. Glad to hear you share his opinion. Thanks. I'm ready when you are.
Lana, I'm heading for Onderon. Gather up anyone that's free and meet me there.
Understood. We'll set out immediately.
So, what do you know about Onderon, Arn?
Well, we just landed in the heart of the capital. Not that there are any other major cities. The planet is mostly wilderness. The wildlife is famously dangerous. The plant life is hardy enough to seed barren planets and spark new ecosystems. So that definitely makes Onderon an important resource world. What else? The planet is ruled by a king named Petrif, who's been on the throne for just over 3 years.
What do you know about the king?
Only that he's not very popular. I didn't really get a chance to dig into his policies to find out why.
Let's find Lana and hear what she's learned about the Imperial's plans.
Lana Beniko, right? The Sith Lord that works for you?
Lana and I don't just work together. We are together.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm sure she's great. I've just never, you know, talked to a Sith Lord before. So, after you?
Commander, welcome to Onderon. This must be your new friend, Arn Perallan. Jedi Padawan,
Nice to meet you.
You're enjoying this a little too much.
I so rarely get to menace innocent young Jedi anymore.
Onderon is a powder keg. King Petrith has been at odds with his noble council for months. From what Theron and I have learned, he wants to strip mine the planet to line his coffers. The nobles aren't interested in that plan. As a result, Petrith has changed residence to his hunting lodge in the wilderness, where the nobles can't keep track of his activities or visitors. The nobles are led by Senator Nibet, the planet's Republic representative. She was kind enough to lend us her office. Nibet's people have detected coded transmissions from the hunting lodge. The code used is highly sophisticated, and not Onderonian.
An Imperial code?
Nibet suspects as much. I have Dr. Ogorob analyzing it to confirm, but in the meantime, the Senator is preparing the city for a potential attack. To that end, our people are spread across the capital, shoring up the city's defenses. I believe you'll find Tau Adair in the central marketplace.
Good work, Lana. I'll take Arn to meet with Tau. Can you arrange an audience with Senator Nibet?
Certainly. I'll contact you once I have the details.
All right, Arn. Ready to meet your new master?
Ready as I'll ever be. It was nice to meet you, Lord. Lady,
Just Lana will do.
Commander, it's good to see you again. You must be Arn.
Yes, Arn Perallan. I look forward to learning from you.
Great. Well, let's get started.
Sounds good. So, where should we start?
I have no idea. Wow.
Why don't you walk Arn through what you're doing out here?
Right, of course. I checked in with the guard station up the street, and now I'm gonna check the walls for...
We're under attack!
Everyone all right?
You two, get to the palace. Coordinate with Lana.
Right away. Arn, are you ready? Arn!
I'm ready.
You're heading for the explosions?
That's usually where the fun is, right?
Enjoy. Let's move.
Commander, you look different somehow. And you arrived even earlier than my most ambitious estimates.
I think I'd remember meeting a... you before.
We'll have an opportunity to get reacquainted later. In person. I'll see to it. The firing sequence is already locked in. My calculations leave no room for error or intervention. You may defeat my remote droids, but not before the orbital defense cannons obliterate the Republic fleet. All units, begin combat recording protocol, Orek. Let's see what you're truly capable of. Impressive.
Republic fleet, raise your shields. Imperial forces set the planet's defensive guns to fire on you. I'm disabling them now, but they may have other tricks up their sleeves.
Understood. Shields up! We'll pull the fleet to a safe distance and maintain alert status.
Tau, this whole attack was a diversion. The Imperials tried to use the defensive cannons to attack our fleet, but I managed to stop them.
That's great to hear, but I'm not sure anyone told these guys they're just a diversion. Think you could give us a hand in the throne room?
On my way.
He was a Koru, leader of the Untamed. They followed the old ways of the Beast Riders, or, at least, their version of the old ways. Commander, I am Senator Nibet. I thank you for your heroism and your timeliness. The deadliest of the attackers were his followers. They're violent isolationists that want all off-world influences killed or driven away. The rest are the King's own soldiers, led to their deaths by Petrith himself. And some kind of droids I don't recognize.
The droids are Imperial. remote piloted. I fought more of them in the control room for the orbital cannons. They actually spoke to me. The woman controlling them claimed to know me, but I didn't learn any more than that.
The coded messages. The Empire must have convinced Petrov that we were plotting against him. Before he retreated, he kept ranting about reclaiming his throne. Though how the Empire could have gotten the Untamed to fight alongside the King is beyond me. Let's see to our wounded and determine the extent of the damage. Then we can reconvene to discuss strategy.
The death toll is still being calculated. At the very least, hundreds of guards and civilians have died. Damage to the city itself was minimal. They attack so quickly that we hardly engage them before they reach the palace.
Our ships in orbit got through without a scratch, thanks to the commander. They should finish refueling within the hour.
Then your mission here is over?
I wish we could stay to help, but with the Imperials heading for Corellia...
We should stay. We have to stay.
I agree. We should stay and help.
It's not just that. The droids that attacked us were being controlled remotely, and you said they spoke with a woman's voice. Darth Savik is the new Dark Council member in charge of scientific research. I read about her in Nostral's files. She uses droids in all of her missions. And I had a look at their internals. The signal range isn't far. That means Savik is on this planet as we speak.
A Dark Council member could tell us a lot about the Empire's plans. If we can find Savik, she'll know which of our other fleets they're targeting.
What else do we know about Darth Savik?
Not much. She seems to avoid the spotlight. Master Nostral suspects she's quietly deleted records of herself from across the galaxy. Only fragments remain.
We can start with King Petrov. If the Sith are manipulating him, they won't be far. He was last seen heading toward his royal hunting lodge.
If you're crossing the Onderon wilds, you'll need guidance. Fortunately, I found just the help you need.
Jakaro, C2D4.
It will be our great pleasure to guide you across our beloved Onderon.
What have you been doing all these years?
We have served moron after moron, fool after fool, but now fortune turns in our favor at last.
We'll leave you to that. It's best if Arna and I stick around to hold the line here in case the imps make another attack. But don't hesitate to call if you need backup.
I assure you, Master Jedi, they're in the best of hands. No, hands. Of course, to the Royal Hunting Lodge!
But this world still has great value to the Empire. Think of the resources. Think of the strategic position.
Worthy objectives for another day. Our focus is Corellia. The Empress has made that clear. Evacuate your remaining forces and go to Rendezvous Point 1. And Savik, the next time I call, you will answer in person.
The nobles! Nabet! They'll have me imprisoned! You promised support! You can't leave me!
Go with my droids, King Petrov. They will keep you safe. Onderon will bow to you again soon enough. You again. You continue to best even my most aggressive estimates. Quite rude.
Leaving so soon? I was looking forward to catching up after all this time.
Don't pretend. You don't remember me at all, I'm sure. This is a neutron emitter. Once fully charged, it will emit a wave of energy fatal to all organic life within range. The range is just enough to engulf the whole building, and the effect lasts for hours. Once you're dead, my droids will have plenty of time to fortify the building against further incursions.
Should we be running away?
You can try.
So, what's the fastest way out of here?
The balcony, obviously. If only someone had been brilliant enough to order that remote piloting system for our ship. And to start flying it here at the first sign of trouble. What genius could have accomplished it?
We'll never hear the end of this, will we?
How about the guards in the East Corridor?
Yes. I feel two of them. They're nervous, but it's a general concern. Nothing threatening.
Dead on. The North Corridor.
Three. But they aren't guards. They feel different. Kitchen staff, I think.
Right again. But can you sense the Commander's Sith friend down in the armory?
No. I can sense the guards there, but no one else. Can't even sense a Sith Lord. Not much good, am I?
I don't sense her either. But that's because she's actually out checking on the main gate. Your friends will make mistakes. Your enemies will lie. Your senses can be deceived. But you can always trust what the Force tells you.
Seems like your training is going well.
Thanks. It's all coming back to me, but there's still so much to learn.
Thank you for your patience. The nobles would rather debate who was most wronged by the King's treason than decide on a course of action.
We were right about Darth Savik and King Petrif. The Sith manipulated him into attacking. But they both managed to escape.
Any hints about where they might go next?
Darth Malgus ordered Savik to leave Onderon, but nothing beyond that.
I think it's time to pay a visit to the other attackers. The Untamed, to fight for the Sith. The Untamed must have been manipulated even more effectively than the King. I'm sure they're all the more frustrated for it. They know the wilderness better than our finest scouts. They have both the motive and means to help you find Savik.
They tried to kill us. Can I really trust them?
I don't understand their code of honor, but they do have one. If you follow it, you should be able to earn their cooperation. They'll be in mourning now. I made sure their dead warriors were returned to them, to comply with the traditions they hold above all else. Light the appropriate beacons as you approach their hideout, and they will treat you with something like respect.
If Senator Nebet agrees, we'll gather volunteers from the City Guard. As soon as you find Savik's location, we'll be ready to launch a coordinated attack.
Of course. Onderon will see justice done. Good luck, Commander.
Koru, we honor the fallen. Offworlder, you observe our rites and customs. You show the respect due to the true masters of this world. We may speak your purpose here. Just be quick about it.
I'm looking for Darth Savik. Do you know where she is?
One offworlder seeking another. Why should we be involved?
Savik betrayed you. If you tell me where she is, she'll face justice. If you don't, you'll be helping her escape.
Justice would be feeding her to Okoro's beasts, alongside Nebet, Petrif, and all others who spoil our world with the influence of outsiders like you. For now, we must lick our wounds and regain our strength. Kill Savik. Take her prisoner. So long as there are less of your kind here, we will celebrate. The ancient proving grounds. Your city dwellers will know where it is. Savik thought she could hide a ship there. From other ignorant offworlders, perhaps. But not from us. You will find her there. Petrif, too. Now go! We will never suffer your presence here again.
The shuttles were pretty well hidden, but we've got a full sensor lock. Now that we know where to look, they won't leave without us knowing.
Volunteers from the city guard are ready and speeders are prepped. We can be there in minutes.
Tau, Arn, you'll take the volunteers and attack from the far side. Make a lot of noise. Draw Savik's attention. I'll go on foot and catch Savik off guard.
Yo, this is Malrev 4 all over again. That's not how I remember it.
The Proving Grounds are ancient and dangerous, even without Imperial patrols. Be cautious. If you manage to find Petrith, please bring him back. The sooner he faces justice for betraying his people, the better. An exiled king can tell his own version of the story, rally supporters, and cause endless trouble. A man in prison is a memory that quickly fades.
I'll do everything I can to bring Petrith back to you.
We are incredibly fortunate to have you for an ally.
Sensors are picking up energy blooms. Might be the shuttles powering up. Better move out.
Everyone look out for each other. Stay in contact. We're almost done. May the Force be with us.
Not so fast. The diversion was impressive, but I know your moves too well to be fooled by a mere imitation.
Now that I see you in person, you do seem familiar. Was it Corellia?
Yes, it was Corellia. You're clear for launch, Petrith. The sensor jammers will activate when you exit orbit. You'll be all but impossible to track.
Await my return, dear Onderon. You shall know the splendor of my rule once again.
Let's ensure a bit of privacy while we're at it. Shuttle 2, commence aerial assault on hostiles in Zone 5. Now then. I've prepared for this day for so long. Where to even begin? You struck me down in my prime, then moved on without a second thought. Corellia would have been my tomb had my droids not found me. In truth, I should thank you. You made me what I am. Taught me the best way to move forward. I haven't risked direct combat in a decade. I send my droids or manipulate fools like Petrith to fight for me. But now, at last, the Force has reunited us. I've spent years studying you, crafting the ideal response to your every tactic. Shall we test what I've learned?
It doesn't sound like you're giving me any other choice.
That's the beauty of my plans. I leave nothing to chance. Hate was supposed to make me stronger. All of my rage, all of these years, it still wasn't enough. I've studied, trained, risen to the Dark Council. What does it take to beat you? How can you be so powerful?
I'm strong because I fight for others. The Force is a part of all living things. How could anyone hope to master it when they only focus on themselves?
Please. It's clear that I'll never beat you. I don't think I even want to anymore. I just want to understand. I can't return to the Sith now. Not after this. They cannot help me become more than I am. Only you can.
Hey there. Sounds like we won.
Everyone all right?
Some of the city guards were hit by the airstrikes, but we're pretty sure they'll make it.
Looks like you have one prisoner. Was Petrith in the other shuttle that launched?
Yes. He left as soon as I got here.
I can help you. You can easily track him down with his sensor jammer's algorithm. I'll give you the algorithm. Whatever you want.
Yeah? How about the other fleets the Empire is targeting? Where will your friend strike next?
Nekshar. It's an old mining outpost that was converted to a fueling station. I don't have the details, but that's our, Malgus's next target.
Really? Just like that?
Let's get back to the palace. We can sort all of this out there.
Sounds good to me.
Then Savik's cooperation is sincere? She's actually told you the Empire's plan?
Seems that way.
I checked with General Dayrune, and we have a fleet headed to Mekshaw for refueling. The pieces fit. Arn and I will head there right away to meet with the fleet's commander, see if we can start rooting out the imps. If we can stop them on Mekshaw like we did here, we might just stand a chance at defending Corellia.
Have any of the Republic's other reinforcements come under attack?
Not yet, but we have all ships on alert. Let's hope they don't try anything else as elaborate as they did here. See you on Mekshaw. Senator, thanks for everything.
Safe travels.
We've got Savik on an Alliance shuttle ready to move out. She says she wants to stay with us. With you, maybe.
Of course, the Republic prefers that we transfer her to their control. How would you like to proceed?
Take Savik to Odessa. She could become a real asset to the Alliance.
Right away.
Please don't make us find some other idiot to work for. That is, we'd much rather work for you.
We'll be glad to have you. Lana can set you up with quarters back on Odessa.
Oh, that's just ridiculous.
We have your ship fueled and ready whenever you wish to depart.
Using Savik's information, we've sent troops to follow King Petrov. We expect to have him back in a matter of days. His trial will be interesting, of course, but I'm more concerned with what will come after. If the nobles can't agree, the question of leadership could turn violent.
You'd make a good queen, Nabet. They should choose you.
Thank you, but I don't want to rule my people. I only want to speak on their behalf and share their wisdom with the rest of the galaxy. Good luck on Mekshaw, Commander, and on Corellia.